If I could change one thing about this tribe.
That we could have cookies.
Wow. Malcolm, Angie, fair answer, says cookies would be good.
You guys haven't been to one yet. They haven't been to one yet.
Let me ask you guys a question. Is this going to be a friendly, we're just going to see how this goes between the five of you for the rest of this challenge?
Yeah, probably.
Why are we wasting our time? I think this is just a big charade, and if really all this is we're just throwing it until we get the person we want to win, just tell me who it's going to be.
Probably my mom's going to win. I'm going to win.
Missy.
Yeah. All right, Missy.
I'm going to win.
Everybody else over here. Missy, come over to me. First time ever.
This is crazy.
A fivesome just going to give it to somebody.
You, Alex, and Roger had the highest IQ. You have a higher IQ than the rocket scientist, for crying out loud. But Jenna, but Heidi, it didn't come out on the show.
No.
Why?
No.
Colby, you have a look on your face like this is annoying or somehow insulting. I handed you the plate and you were like, I don't want this.
I'm not annoyed with you. I'm ready to get to the challenge.
Free offer of chocolate. I'm just curious.
Let's go.
I got the message, brother. We'll go when I'm ready. Rupert.
He's a warrior. He's a dragon slayer. He's
a warrior.
That's what he says. He's a warrior.
That's what you said.
Because that's what he calls himself.
I didn't come up with that, by the way.
Let me guess, some chief in a small village.
That's fine. Hey, every time we come in here and you want to try to cut me down because you want to try to ferret out the truth, I love it.
Okay. Purple Kelly, weigh in on this. Give us 20 years of wisdom.
Well, let me tell you, 20 years of wisdom. I think that this is the first tribal council I felt completely out of the loop on what's going on, to be completely honest.
Have you been learning stuff tonight?
Yes.
Alabama off to a slow start. Katie really slowing him down on a very easy portion of this challenge. A huge setback for Calabal. Here comes Calabal. Katie once again laps one over. Katie struggling.
Go!
Calabal on their last bit of rope trying to get through that drawbridge. Still suffering from the beginning with Katie. Tandang with a big head start, and it still goes back to the first leg of this challenge. Katie could not get over the mound. Survivor's ready. Katie, hand on the pole.
Oh, sorry.
Lisa goes deep. RC and Katie can't connect. Katie, completely ineffective in this challenge.
Katie, are you mad at me? It seemed like I was always saying Katie in the rear, Katie
every
behind.
Every single time. I got it after the sixth time, okay? I gotcha, but it's all good, I forgive you.
This would be like, I'm out. Now would be a good time to exit.
Well, so I guess you just told these guys that you're fine going home.
All I'm saying is that I wouldn't mind, you know, saying, okay, great, guys, do your business.
Well, for the time being, you're still in this game.
Thanks, Jeff.
You'll be going to Exile Island.
Oh, geez, thanks. That's just great, thanks.
So maybe a little time on Exile, straighten out your head, you'll come back wanting to play.
I don't think mine's balanced properly, Jeff.
Glad you're still around, Jean-Robert. Always need a complainer.
I thought I was the complainer.
Day 37 is here. John and three women in bed, another first.
Actually, not really.
Coach, get your hand on the bag. No, no, replaying. No, no, no. Coach.
You all
come
over here.
No.
No.
Do over. Coach, inadvertent or not, you used your arm. Take that anger and point it to the pirate, not me.
Lindsay.
Guys, it's a game.
Lindsay, where are you going? Sit it. That's three votes, Lindsay, three votes, Tom. We're gonna vote again.
Coda on their last part of the puzzle now. This challenge is an absolute blowout at this point.
It might be time to put it in the deep freeze, Jillian. You might be out of it.
Nothing's gone till it's gone.
8 items.
What?
What is that?
Don't worry about it.
Roseanne, not even close. The men continue to be pathetic in this challenge. Women don't have it right either. Re-rack will go again. Here we go. Roseanne is not right. Kat is not right. Re-rack and we go again. Kat thinks she has it right. No, men have it wrong as well. Re-rack, we go again. She is wrong. He is wrong. No, wrong. No, re-rack, go again.
One thing before we get going. Nobody else on
Wait, do you have the flint in your hand?
Nobody else on my team really had the courage to bring this up to you. So we actually found our other flint. This one hasn't been...
fantastic.
Hey, listen. This one has not been struck one time.
Okay.
And I was wondering if there was some reasonable trade we could do, maybe half the fishing gear, maybe just a mask, a snorkel, and a spear, just something to put some food on the table.
Right.
Oh, my gosh.
So now, because this one is still brand new, basically straight out of the box, you want to make a return.
What's your return policy, Jack?
Exchange.
Well, it sounds reasonable.
Exactly.
Right.
I feel like you're taunting us.
I am taunting you. Put the flint back. You made the trade.
Yeah. Good effort. I like the effort.
Well, there's absolutely no loyalty in tonight's vote. It's full of liars and backstabbers. End of story.
End of story? No, just beginning of story. I want more.
You can kind of say, you know, what you want to say to kind of build your case and make your case, but, I mean, at the end of the day, it comes down to, you know, what's in everybody's best interest to move their game forward.
Allie, JP gave a really interesting answer to a very specific question by saying nothing. I don't see anybody else playing as laid back right now as JP.
You will be going into this game wearing the clothes on your back.
These are like 20 pounds each. I don't have on a bra.
Well, that's going to make you either very popular or a big liability if you let it get in the way of challenges or camp life.
Yeah.
All right. You'll have a bath, you'll have a massage, and then a nice afternoon lunch. Carter, you might want to try a pedicure.
I need one.
Pedicure would be the feet, not the fingers, but either one will work.
Good eye.
Yeah. Laurel thinks she has it. Laurel wins individual immunity. Safe tonight at Tribal Council. Cannot be voted out of this game.
I guess I had to scream your name, I guess.
What? Did you call me?
I didn't call you.
Oh, you gotta call it. Wendell, I mean, you understand, right? Because a puzzle's not done until you tell me.
Austin, per your wishes, go home. All due respect to Austin, people work too damn hard to get in this game and fight to stay alive. He wants to lay his torch down, so it shall be. Who knows, maybe this is the best thing to happen to the Morgan tribe. And cocktails.
Oh! That was talking.
And soft drinks for Will.
Will, you know you can't drink beer, right?
Yeah, I
know. Okay.
We're down to 9.
Reed.
I did, I held it right there. Good, smooth.
Colby blaming everything on his big brother. He's been that way 34 days, Reed.
Come on, Reed, skip!
Little brother getting frustrated with his big brother.
Ryan, it's kind of like you're in a relationship.
I've never been in a relationship.
Okay.
So, Fabio, are you hearing what's happening right now?
It sounds like if I don't win again, I could be going next.
It's writing on the wall, Fabio.
You have 3 people just told you, flat out, that there is a 3-person alliance. There are 3 other people, Dan, Fabio, and Jane. So let me ask you the question that my mom would want asked, which is, why don't they have their own alliance and try to do something or force a vote? It seems crazy.
I've got burnt 2 times by women, okay? Women should hold themselves to a higher standard and they should respect themselves because that's how my mother did it. And nowadays, girls don't respect themselves.
And are you able to separate yourself and say, I know that comment just offended millions of women?
What? That women should hold themselves at a higher respect?
I gotta say, Rodney, for what it's worth, it is ultimately a social game. You are aware that you're playing with fire a little bit with that kind of attitude, right?
I know that they're coming from my head.
What I was trying to tell them was that in the alliance that I made with someone else, I probably spoke to that person about what we were planning on doing. Like,
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you
Nobody
mean?
Does.
John, self-proclaimed good strategist. What are you basing your vote on tonight?
By whatever the astrological signs tell me.
Is that a respectful way to treat somebody that you've lived with for 12 days?
Maybe. Maybe not. We'll find out in a few minutes.
You are one of only four people to make it to the end twice. You, Sandra, Parvati, and Russell are the only four people who've done that. And yet there's this one quality that seems to elude you, and it's that killer instinct. Does this haunt you in life as well, where you just can't?
Wow.
No, Amanda, I'm not picking on you. It's what everyone on the street says is she's such a good player, but then you back off.
Natalie, still inexplicably working on her first section, knocking pieces out. Natalie is still on the first section. Natalie, out of this challenge. You might as well sit down and watch. Natalie totally lost. Natalie being a good sport and still running around. Natalie, one bag, has only one bag. Natalie, once again, completely out of this challenge.
What is it?
If it's a steak, I quit. But if it's not, I want to stick it.
No.
You didn't even wait for that way.
Alexis got so excited. No. I hadn't even said what it was.
No. She doesn't get it?
No chance. You got excited. You're out.
Dum, dum, dum.
Alexis, why?
You can mope and be mad. Just so we're clear, if you want this chocolate chip cookie and milk.
Again, from Survivor 1. Which of the original castaways used the alphabet strategy when voting tribe members off the island?
Fabio, I don't like you.
Okay. Fabio, she don't like you.
That attitude has been present the whole time. And I have tried to keep it cool, but it's obviously hard to do that.
He don't try hard enough.
Nayanka, you a little complicated?
Me?
You too.
Okay, I gotta say, I'm... God, Nayanka, I think I'm speechless.
And you should see the jackets. I'm sorry, I had to go there.
Natalie, I think I just figured you out. You need the last word.
Yep.
Is that fair?
No. Not always.
Jackets and eggs. It has been a lively tribal council.
I gotta say, there has never been a tribe in the history of Survivor that has needed as much help as you guys have, and only 14 days in. First, you lose your flint. You lose fire. And have to trade your entire fishing reward to get a new one, and now you're completely out of rice and you need help again. And it's not lost on me that the disproportionate amount of food that you guys have had is probably a big part of the reason that you have dominated in this game so far and the challenges. So in fairness of the game and in fairness to the Coyopa tribe, who's playing the way you should, the penalty for that has to be just. So I have enough rice to last you the rest of the game. But it's going to be a stiff penalty. Here's what I want. Your tarp, your hammock, your bedroll, the pillows, the blankets, the candles, everything you won in the comfort reward. The hatchet, the hammer, one of the pots, and the extra flint. That's gonna leave you with a machete, a pot, and a flint. You are starting over. Mm.